What's going on, guys? It is Bernardo, and today is all about enhanced security with Microsoft Intra Token Theft Protection. So let's get right into it. All right, Microsoft Token Theft Protection, which they actually had this within the preview mode, and I think they made it public not too long ago. So, what are tokens and why they matter? Tokens let apps authenticate users without asking for credentials repeatedly. This is great for those individuals that, you know, hate remembering their passwords. Plus, we tell them to change their password for each login. A lot of people like to use the same one, change it, mix it up, but they don't want to remember all those passwords. It's super convenient, but it is a hot topic for, you know, today's hackers. Now, Microsoft introduced token binding to help stop hijacking. What is token theft? Attackers steal authentication tokens stored on devices. Even with MFA enabled within your account, stolen tokens let hackers impersonate users. I have seen this. This is crazy. This is wild, right? An example would be clicking a malicious email link. Hackers grab that token and they fully have access to your OneDrive, your Outlook, and everything else. Now, common attack methods, man in the middle, malware, phishing, and insecure logs. Now, Microsoft actually gave us a way to prevent this issue to happen within your, you know, Microsoft 365 tenants, your users. To do this, we need to create a conditional policy. Now, first thing that we need to do is log into our Microsoft 365 Admin Center, which would be right here. Here we go. On the left-hand side, we are going to click on Show All, and we're going to locate Identity. So locate it and click on it. It's going to take you here. So on the left-hand side, we are going to locate Conditional Access. So click on that. And on the Conditional Access Overview, underneath Overview, we're going to click on Policies. Right there, New Policy, click on that. And it's going to take you here. First thing that we need to do is provide a name. So I'm going to give it the following. Next thing that we need to do underneath users, zero users and groups selected. That is a hyperlink. So click on that. And we're going to select users and groups. I'm going to check off users and groups. And underneath select zero users and groups selected, that is a hyperlink. So click on that and then select your group. I do recommend doing this on a small group before you push it out to the masses. Do like a nice little self-contained group, like a pilot. Make sure everything is working properly. And then once you're satisfied, push out the conditional policies to all of your users. We're going to click select here. And next thing that we need to do is underneath target resources, click on no target resources selected. That is a hyperlink. We're going to select resources, and underneath select, let's click on none. We're going to type in Office 365, so type it in. Once you type it in, hit enter so you can search, and the first one that we are going to check off will be the Office 365 Exchange Online, so give it a check. We're going to scroll down and locate Office 365 SharePoint Online. That will be the second resource, and we're going to click on select. Now, next section that we need to go into will be grants. So underneath grants, click on zero control selected. That is a hyperlink. So click on it. And on the right-hand side, choose your grant. For this example and this video, I'm going to choose require multi-factor authentication, but you are able to configure it within your environment the way that you want it. Just make sure you test it out. Click on select. Now, next section that we need to go is sessions. So underneath sessions, click on zero control selected. And there goes the new option, required token protection for sign-in sessions. Again, during the time that I took these snapshots, it was on preview, but I believe a couple weeks ago, maybe a month ago, Microsoft actually made it public. So let's check that off. And we're going to click on select. And then once you're done, click on create, and then that's it. Hopefully you guys enjoy this video, and I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.